One of the most powerful features of Softr is its ability to allow you to set predefined user groups and then assigning, editing, or CRUD permissions to those defined user groups so that they can edit and update information within your database, all without ever touching the original database itself. So before we dive into action buttons and how you can set this up, you want to make sure that you have your user groups already defined within Softr. If you haven't done that already and are looking for a guide, I'll link a video in the show notes of this tutorial. Once you have your user groups defined, you want to think about what CRUD operations you want to give to individual user groups. Specifically within Softr, your users have the option to either add a new record or update an existing record, or you can choose to give them neither of those options. Now, the primary way you activate this is through the use of action buttons. The first version of action buttons were released this month in March of 2023. However, there will be more improvements to come, such as giving your users the ability to delete fields, update fields, bulk edit, and more. But for now, let's dive into this powerful feature. So for this demonstration, let's use the project tracker template, which is found in the Softr template library, where you can copy this template into your Softr Studio for free. We're going to demonstrate action buttons on the home page of this template, as shown here. This displays a list block that shows all projects happening at any given time. This list block corresponds with the projects table, which is found here within the Airtable Project Management by Softr database. Now, for this app, we've gone ahead and set up our two user groups, which are employee and manager, and correspond to the employee and manager single select role found under the team table here. Setting up your user groups is the first important step before assigning CRUD operations within your action button. So make sure you go ahead and do that, and be sure to watch the previous video if you need help understanding user groups. Now, one thing to note that if you have an existing block where you want to implement action button functionality, you will actually be prompted to update your block to implement action buttons. What this will do is essentially create a new block, and you will need to remap the fields for the time being. This will change in the future to make it more seamless. We will provide a one-click update, but for now, you will need to remap the fields on the corresponding block where you want the action button to take place. I've gone ahead and already done that here, but feel free to pause the video and do that as you need to now. You'll connect the source as well as the content item fields. Once you're there, hit play and let's continue on to implementing action buttons. Now, let's say within this project list, I only want to give managers the ability to add new projects to the app and edit and update existing product information all within the Softr app. We can easily assign that within the Action Buttons tab found here. You'll notice when we toggle over to Action, there's two options to choose from: top bar buttons and item buttons. For the first option, top bar buttons, these are buttons that are placed above a list to perform table level actions, such as adding a new record, opening a static URL page modal, downloading a list, and eventually bulk actions, which are coming soon. For this purpose, we want to allow our users to add a new record to this database and corresponding Softr app. So let's go ahead and go over here and add a top bar button. So we're gonna go to add top bar and add record. First, you can rename the label so you know what this is. Let's just say add new project. Next up, we need to add our item fields. So essentially what you wanna do is ask yourself, out of this table level action, what fields do I want this user to be able to add to? So for this, I would like to make all of these fields available as it's adding an entirely new project to this database. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that by checking out my corresponding field. So the first one is gonna be text. We're gonna map it to the project name, and then we're gonna label it as such. You can also add a placeholder, and you can make this required or not required. I'm gonna make it required so we make sure it at least has a name. So you'll continue to do this for the rest of the fields that you want available for the top bar button. Okay, once you've added all of your records, then you'll scroll down and edit your modal settings. So essentially the modal is what's going to pop up when the user clicks on add new project or the top bar button. So instead of add new record, let's actually call it add new project, as that makes more sense to the user. save button can be add, close button can be cancel, and then it will say new project added successfully. Okay, cool. So the last step is setting the button visibility settings. So essentially, who can see this button? We want it to be logged in users, and then we want it to be managers, because as we said at the beginning of this tutorial, we want only managers to have the capability to add a new project to this list block. So if a manager is logged in, they will essentially see the action button and be able to do that. If an employee is logged in, this action button will not be visible to them. And that's how you simply set editing permissions now. Pretty straightforward, right? So let's publish this and take a look at what it looks like as a manager. So if I go to my team table and head to users, let's see, Michelle or Rose. Rose is a manager. So let's log in as Rose and see what this looks like. Great. So if I click on add new project, you'll see the modal pops up, add new project. Here I can add new project name, dummy text for description. The status is to do because it's a new project. The value of the project, let's say 10,000, and the deadline is, let's say June 30th. Now we will add it. You will see add new project name has now been added to the list. And then if we head over to our corresponding database and the projects table, let's give it a quick refresh. And we'll see it's automatically been added here. Add new project name with the corresponding information. Great. Now let's take a look at the second action option, which is the update record option, found under the item button section under the actions tab. So essentially, if we go to add item button and update record, we will see here that this action allows your users to essentially edit an existing record through a pop-up form. You get to define which fields and inputs to show, how they should be called, in what order to display them in, and whether they're required or not. Additionally, you'll see that the buttons quite obviously appear on the individual list items because you're essentially updating the individual records rather than adding a brand new record to the database, which is what this top bar action button allows you to do. So let's say, like for this button, we want to allow managers and employees to change the status of the project. So we would simply choose update record as we've done here. Then we would map the status field. So let's actually delete all of these because we only want the status field. It's already mapped to status. Great. We can sync the options with the data source. Perfect. Let's add a label, which is going to be project status. And then let's hit it as required. Additionally, let's not forget to change our modal setting. So project status can go here, save button, update, close buttons, cancel, and the project status has been updated successfully. Great. So once we've connected the proper fields and updated the modal settings, the last step, of course, is defining the button visibility. So again, we want this to be available to, of course, logged in users. And the specific user group is going to be not only managers, but also employees. Perfect. Now let's publish that and let's take a look at what it looks like. Perfect. So if we go to website audit version 2, we click update. Right now it's in progress. Now I can change it to complete and update that. Let's head back over to our database and you'll see it's already been updated. Pretty cool, right? Now, this is what it looks like if I'm logged in as a manager. Let's also quickly see what it looks like if I'm logged in as an employee, which Michelle, if we recall, is an employee. So for Michelle, she cannot see the top bar option, which is correct because we don't want Michelle to be able to add a new project to the database. However, she still has the ability to go into a project and edit the status. Great, that's exactly how we set it up. Now, it's important to note, you can add several action buttons if needed to both the top bar and item button. So for example, you could have one button that is visible only to employees and allows them to only update the status. Then you could add a second button that allows managers to update all records within the list item. That button would only show up for managers, and so on and so forth. The options are endless. Now, to quickly demonstrate what adding several buttons looks like within your list block, let's just take a quick look. So for the top bar button, let's say like I wanted to add an additional record action button. In the top bar button, you can see two buttons here. Great. Now, if you were to add a third button, what's going to happen is we're going to see an icon with three dots, which essentially allows the user to click into the three dots, which will take them to the third button option. This is from a UX perspective, just trying to keep your apps looking nice and clean without overwhelm of many, many different buttons sitting next to each other. The same behavior is going to happen on a list block like this one. If you add an additional button here, you'll see the three icon. The user will click into this icon, which will then show the additional buttons that they can choose from. Now, there are other list blocks that will actually show two item buttons if you prefer that visually. So just know that's available to you on different list blocks. And then the last step, of course, is styling your buttons. So in order to style your buttons, all you simply need to do is hover over each individual button, click on the three dots, button styles, and here you can essentially set the site styles of your buttons. Now, lastly, as you can see with this template, the old way of adding new records was to use a softer form. Now, action buttons actually replaces that need, so we can delete this block altogether. Now, there's a lot more to come with action buttons. This is only version one. We have a lot more to look forward to, which will include allowing users to delete records, updating fields, bulk actions, the ability to integrate with Make and Zapier, setting icons, and more. So be sure to stay tuned as we roll out the additional versions of the action buttons. But for now, dive into your Softr app, see what's available to you, and have fun with version one of action buttons.